Hi, this is Librarian in the Attic. I'd like to talk to you about a realistic fiction book in our collection, The Lines We Cross by Rhonda Abdul Fattah. The author is from Australia and the book is set in Australia. And it goes back and forth between two perspectives. One perspective is a boy named Michael, and Michael's parents are in charge of an organization that is a strongly anti-immigrant organization. They believe that immigrants should not be allowed into Australia unless they come legally. And it kind of has strong racist overtones to it. The other character's name is Mina, and she and her family are from Afghanistan, and they came to Australia illegally to escape terrible violence in Afghanistan that actually killed Mina's younger brother, and she still sometimes has nightmares about her brother's death. Anyway, Michael and Mina meet at school, and Mina doesn't pay him much attention at first, but she starts to understand that his parents are part of this organization that's against people like her and her family. And not only that, this organization has done things to try to hurt her family's restaurant. So she challenges Michael on that and tells him he needs to really think hard about, does he really believe this or not? And there's some romantic attraction from that Michael likes Mina, but he realizes he's really got to think about this. So as he does his research and starts to observe more about how his parents' organization works, he ends up turning against it and becomes a strong, confident anti-racist, not only against his parents, but against this boy at school who's sort of the class clown, but also is just a mean kid who has some of the same views as his parents. So he really grows a lot through the book, and Mina ends up liking him back. So it's got a strong message, and it's well written. It sort of reminds me of All American Boys. The Lines We Cross by Rhonda Abdul Fattah. We have it in our collection, and we hope you'll come and read it. Talk to you later.